I've had an interest in some of the unusual instruments. I'm not particularly good at playing instruments of any sort, but the Native American flute is something that I like the sound of. And while I'm not going to go through how to make a flute, I'm going to show you something about hanging these, displaying them if you decide to make them. What I will do is actually link to a very, very good site. The guy has been making flutes for years. He's a Cherokee, and he gives a very good explanation how to build a flute, how to tune it, how to get over little problems and things like that. So you should go and have a look at it if you're interested in Native American music and flutes. This is my first attempt. And no, I didn't carve that dolphin on the top. That's actually from some sort of pull cord, possibly from a bathroom light switch or something like that, or something that had a string attached to it. Well, I picked it up somewhere and thought that might look good on a flute. So I've actually made another one. First one I'm sort of happy with, but then decided I was going to go and build another one out of another piece of bamboo. These pieces of bamboo actually came from a hall stand, which my dad turned into a little table many years ago, chopping off the top of it. And it's just got in the way for me, so I took it apart, kept the pieces of bamboo, and then it suddenly dawned on me that maybe I can make use of them as flutes. And I like this one because it's got a bit of a bend on the end. Gives it a bit of an unusual shape. But yeah, you can get a sound out of it. This one needs tuning, well, the other one does as well. Need to do that. But today what I'm going to do is show you how to make some sort of display. There are many ways of doing things. You can have a mono, a table stand with legs sticking up, and pieces of bamboo as the cradles for them. This one is going to be a wall hanging device, and so what I'll do is get myself a hole saw that's larger than the end of the largest flute I'm going to be displaying, and displaying these flutes is probably going to be the most of it, although the grandchildren might have a go at learning to play them. But I decide roughly how far away from the top I want the first one. So your first one is going to have a sort of cradle in there like that, and then that will be cut back ready for the next one. So then you decide that you want to put it in about there somewhere. Then what I do is I find a block of wood that I can go from centre to centre and go down and mark each one in turn. I've already started doing one. Let's put this cutter back in. And the way I've set this up is that the wood goes back against the fence, so I've got a line that way, and then I use the centre marks to come down on there. I've gone down not quite all the way through, and this is where I want to do the other one, because there's going to be two vertical rails. So you line up the two rails, and then what we're going to do is to plunge through the first one and make a mark in the second one. I'm going to take these pieces out by going from the other side, so I'll just go and do that, probably speed up the video while I get on with it. So that's the bottom piece marked with I'll carry on and do the drilling of these. Next stage is to remove the rest of these holes, and the best way to get tear out is to go from the back. Yeah, you've got to stop each time to remove the wood plug that comes out of it. That's the two bars, and we've just got to make it so you can accept the flutes in there, make it look reasonable. And I don't muck about with measurements and things like that when I don't have to. It's just a simple case of lining up a piece of wood on the back of one of the holes and on the point of the other hole, and marking a line, so that gives me a bit of a hook. And then once I know the rough angle of that, I can go to the top one and just mark a similar line there, and then I'll go down the whole lot and cut those pieces out with a saw, most likely the hand saw, because circular saws are not very good at getting into edges and that. So I'll do that and I'll come back and show you the result. So okay, there's the finished rack. What I've done there is use a router to round over the corners all the way around, so it looks nice and smooth, and made a back panel. It's actually three strips of wood there that are joined together, because I didn't have one that was wide enough, and the edge I've also routed to give a bit of a feature. A little bit of sanding to do before I finally finish, put whatever coating I want on there, and that will take the flutes quite nicely however you want to arrange them. Not only for flutes, if you're as long as you're keeping it legal, depending on which country you're in. If you've got display knives and things like that, you can display them on a rack like this. So hopefully it comes in useful for other things. And for those who have got short flutes or whistles or short knives, it might look a bit odd like that. What I probably would do with this one, I haven't fixed the top yet, but you can actually bring the tops in to make it look a bit different. Obviously you need to be able to balance your flutes or whatever on there, but yeah, it's fairly versatile and can be used for more than just flutes and whistles. As I said at the beginning of the video, I will not be showing you how to make flutes. That's not my scene. I'm interested in the sound of the Native American flute and a few others, including things like the pan pipes, etc., which is another sort of thing I want to have a go with. I can't play flutes, but it's interesting nonetheless, to be able to get a sound out of something you've made yourself. But if you want to make your own flutes, I mentioned a guy at the beginning of the video. His website is Blue Bear Arts, and he has a video channel as well, which I'll link to both in the description. He's a great guy. As I say, he's a Cherokee. He's taught by his grandfather and things like that. And you get an occasional story out of him about his history, and a few funny comments as well. So, you know, it's a very light-hearted way of showing you how to make flutes. I've seen many videos on flute making. Maybe I haven't seen them all, but this guy, he is the best I've ever seen so far. Apologies to anyone who may be better. I don't know. So, yeah, that's the flute rack. One other thing, if you don't want to fix it to the wall, you could hinge something on the back as a stand with a strap to stop it from going too far. This is just a basic design that you can work from, and get something that you can display your work.